Hello, I'm Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today, we're talking about triads played across the keys, first, fourth, and fifth chords, the 1, 4, 5. Now, these chords are all going to be diatonic to the key of C major for this lesson, and I've placed them across three areas of the guitar neck to make them easy to play and quick to memorize. In this lesson, we'll find out how they work in the major tonality, we'll learn about triad inversions, and I'll show you how to move the chords to new fret positions and new string sets. After this, join me for the second half of this lesson over on my Patreon page, where I've composed a 1-4-5 chord progression that uses a collection of popular chord shapes. And from the harmony, I'll show you how to take it to the next level by incorporating the triad inversions that we'll cover here in this YouTube lesson. But first, before we get started, a quick word about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. With triads, the harmony is based upon three notes, and we refer to that three-note group as the chord's chord tones. Now, the chord tones are made up of a root, a third degree, and a fifth, and the chord can be established in any one of those locations. So we can get inversions out of that process. We'll call it root position when the root is in the bass. When the third is in the bass, we call it first inversion, and when the fifth is in the bass, we call it second inversion. So when you take these triads and you build harmonies with them and they get applied within a key, they establish a song's chord progression. And we'll quite often find that one of the most popular progressions out there is using the first, fourth, and fifth steps of the scale, which in music theory is what we call playing a 1-4-5 progression. So let's get started by learning the triads in three fret areas, and then we'll apply the chords in a 1-4-5 example progression. We're going to be covering three groups of the triads across the neck in the 1-4-5 format. One group of them will be down here in the low neck region, the other group will be in the middle, and the other group that we have will be up on the higher strings. Now, these are all going to be set up on the string set, so our first group is going to be based between 5th, 4th, and 3rd. The root chord, the one chord is C major because we're doing all these examples in the key of C, and this is going to be C, E, and G. Based on the open positions, so 3rd fret, 2nd fret, and open 3rd string for our C chord with the C root in the bass. The next chord is going to be our 4 chord of F, but this one's going to be inverted to have the C in the bass. That's the 5th chord tone in the bass. We call this a 2nd inversion triad. So in this case, we've got C, F, and A on the 5th, 4th, and 3rd strings with setup of a F chord with C in the bass. All right, our last one, our 5 chord of the key is going to be a G chord, but it's going to have B in the bass to cover the notes across there for the G chord on those 5th, 4th, and 3rd strings. So we get a B down below, open 4th string D, and then open 3rd string G up top. So that's called a first inversion because the 3rd chord tone, the B, is in the bass. All right, so that's our first group in the open position there, low neck region. We're going to move up next to the middle of the neck here, and we're going to set up a new C major 1-4-5 triad collection in the mid-neck region. And we're going to start off with a bar here. This is going to be between the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. This is our C chord, our root chord. So this is now a C chord with G in the bass, though. So it's called 2nd inversion. G in the bass, 5th chord tone in the bass. Easy to play, just a bar that we're doing. You could do that with 3rd finger maybe as well, whichever finger feels comfortable for you. It depends where you're going along the neck. You know, we're going to be heading forward next, so we're going to be doing the F chord, the 4 chord of the key. And this inversion is F chord with A in the bass, so that's a 1st inversion. The major 3rd is in the bass, so we've got that A, C, and F from 4th to 3rd to 2nd strings in the 5th position there. And then to wrap everything up with our 5 chord, we're going to go down a little bit here into the 3rd position. We get a root position G chord, G, B, D, just like that across those strings. Really easy shape too. Ring finger, middle, and index. All right, and then we're back here. So you can hear the resolution too. It's a strong pull that we've got from our root chord to the four chord, and five chord wants to pull us back home. All right, so now we've carried through into the middle neck region. I got one more region left for you yet, and it's going to be up high. Top three strings in eighth fret position here for our first chord setup for the root chord of C major. It's got an E in the bass, so that's going to be the first inversion with the major third in the bass of E. Easy chord to make, middle finger and index, you know, just setting it up on the neck there with that little bar we're doing with index, top two strings. And then the next chord, the four chord of the key, this one's going to be in root position. So the F is in the lowest tone position. So we've got F, A, C across the neck in eighth fret area there. And then the last chord is going to be our five chord of G. So that's going to set us up in the seventh fret position. So we've got index finger down below. We've got that ring finger in middle up top. Really, it's a D chord shape. If you're familiar with your D major chord, that's all it really is. It's just brought up here. It's got the D in the bass on this one, and that's called second inversion because the fifth is the lowest tone. And then we go back to hear that resolution. Keep that in mind because when they come back around from that five chord, it's a really strong resolution. Now, we've got a lot of chords here to deal with now, and you have to practice them in some way. So what I've got coming up for you next is a nice progression. Now, if you are a Patreon member, you're going to get a jam track. It's this one right here. So it's just a nice laid-back jam that we got going on with the C, F, G, and C chords. And what we're going to do is go through each position across the neck, do the low, the middle, and the high positions, and get a whole cycle of these chords moving along the fretboard so that you can practice each of the shapes. All right, so let's get started. So that's our low versions there. Let's go middle and neck. Now up high. All right. So if you are a Patreon member over at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio, you're going to get a handout for this lesson. You're going to get a second video that's going to go into even more depth with all this stuff. And you're also going to get jam tracks, and that's one of them. So it's going to be a lot of fun over there because I got a whole bunch of new ideas I want to cover with you, more so on what it's like to set up a progression in one area of the neck and then use the triads to take it elsewhere along the fingerboard. And that's mainly what winds up happening when you're applying these types of chords along the neck. There's a lot of mileage that you can get out of these things, and they work fantastic in a couple specific situations too. Like if you're in a band and you got a keyboard player, you can really stay out of their way by doing some smaller upper region triads along the fretboard, and it'll really sound nice in conjunction layering against the keyboard parts. Plus, if you're in a band with two guitar players, you can get, you know, one guitar player can be playing in one region, and then the other guitarist can go in another region, and if you wanted to, maybe if it's a chord progression with a lot of changes with chord harmonies, you can play a bunch of these triads along the fretboard, and man, it sounds absolutely excellent. So now you've got all these different triad versions. They're really basic, they're easy to play, they sound beautiful, they're tons of fun, and I think you're going to be able to get them into your playing fairly quickly. If you are a Patreon member over at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio, like I said, I'm going to take things a little bit more in depth with this whole triad world. We're going to take a new progression, a pretty commonplace sounding progression, and then we're going to redo it, kind of whole, you know, remake job on that progression and convert it to using these triads that we've just covered here on the YouTube lesson. Now, also I want to mention that if you need a little bit of extra help with your guitar playing and your studies, go check out my website over at creativeguitarstudio.com. I got all my courses over there. There's some great stuff if you want to study the actual curriculum of my beginner, intermediate, and advanced courses. If you want to study some of the electives like acoustic guitar, guitar solo, soloing, guitar technique, music reading, ear training, the songs programs. There's tons of stuff over there, and the memberships are very reasonably priced. Go check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. Otherwise, I'll catch up with you for the part two video and the full next lesson coming up on Patreon next. I hope to see you there. Once again, the address is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I've composed another 1-4-5 chord progression. We'll start by learning it and we'll play it. And then from that point, we're going to go through the harmony. And I'm going to show you how to take it to the next level by incorporating those triad inversions that we just covered here in this YouTube lesson. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get a jam track, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.